Bonjour everyone and welcome back to my channel, The Waves of Your Soul. Today I really felt called to be doing a reading that was focused around healing, nurturing messages, something along the line of self-care, self-love. How may we be getting a hug from the universe? This is the vibe. I'm not sure what I've called this reading. I guess you'll see from the title of today's video. But it was really something I felt called to do, something that was along the lines of taking care of oneself, loving oneself, healing. So this reading is going to be particularly helpful if you're going through a tough time right now, if you need a gentle guidance, if you need something that's not going to be too punchy, but still empowering, because I am not here to be stroking your egos. This is not what this channel is about. We're always doing readings that are meant to be empowering, but also meant to allow us to evolve, to grow. But today, really, I chose decks that were a lot more gentle. And like I say with all of my readings, they are for the collective. So please use what resonates with you and leave the rest. The entirety of the reading might not speak to you, but that's okay. You can trust your inner guidance. You can trust your own intuition. So for anyone who's not been on my channel before, I want to say a huge welcome. My name is Marine. I'm a French tarot reader and a lover of everything tarot, oracle and self-empowerment related. So if you'd like to see any of those things on your timeline, as well as empowering tarot reading, intuitive guidance, content on tarot, oracle and all of that good stuff, then make sure to hit the subscribe button because I upload every single week. So if you don't know how pick a pile reading works, in front of you, you're going to see three different piles. This is pile number one, this is pile number two, and this is pile number three. All you need to do is intuitively decide which is the pile that is calling out to you the most, and then you will find in the description box below timestamps that can take you straight to your reading. I pull tarot and oracle cards on the go because I like my readings to be organic, so we're gonna be doing that together. Today, as you can see, you have three different tarot decks to choose from, so you can intuitively choose from the backs. They are all gonna be gentle decks, they're all not gonna be very, you know, confrontational or anything like that. But I'm also gonna be pulling a little image that can help you choose for each of the decks. And if you don't want to choose just with that, you can also choose thanks to this image. Okay, so for pile number one, you can choose this. This is for pile number one. We have a nature kind of setup here with praying mantis, a spider, a snake, some flowers. For pile number two, we have a very cute rabbit. And finally, for pile number three, you can also choose, thanks to this beautiful, what is that? I forgot the name in English now. English is not my first language, but that will come back to me. I know this bird, hummingbird. So there you go. You can also choose, thanks to those three images, intuitively as well, to decide which is the pile that is calling out to you the most. Anybody who needs a bit more time to choose the pile that is calling out the most to them, I'm gonna insert a very quick 30-second meditation video where you can take some deep breaths, release any tension you might be holding on to, connect to the waves of your soul. For anyone else, you can head straight to your reading starting now. Okay, my pile number one, this is gonna be your self-care, self-love, healing reading, a hug from the universe. So if you chose this purple backing, or with which is actually the Cosmic Cycles tarot, or if you chose thanks to this particular image, then this is gonna be the reading for you. So like I said, today's reading is very much inspired by self-care, self-healing, getting a nice hug from the universe. And the first thing we're gonna be doing is finding out a little bit more about your current state of mind and potentially what could help you feeling better if you're feeling a certain type of way. So this is going to be current state of mind. This is going to be what you can do to improve it, to feel better physically, emotionally, spiritually. We're also going to be looking at potentially what's stopping you from taking that step. Maybe you know what should be good for you, but you haven't committed to it yet. We're going to be finding out why. And finally, we're going to be looking at potentially the benefit of you taking care of this, overcoming that hurdle and really committing to that self-care, healing activity or behavior, etc. And finally, we'll be putting some tarot cards around how to keep going, how to move forward, okay? So first up, let's look at your current state of mind, current well-being. We have the Chariot, beautiful card. Love that. So you've been on the go, you've been focusing on your dreams, you've been working hard. For my pal number one, you've been really dedicated, committing your time to your career or your family life or your goals in general, maybe some even fitness goals you had, whatever it is. There's a strong idea here that you've been very much focusing on going forward. You haven't given yourself a lot of time for rest. You've just been pushing yourself hard to achieve your goals, which can be a great thing. I mean, the Chariot is usually a card that is linked with successful endeavors, so whatever you're doing is gonna pay off. But sometimes, you know, we don't want to be spending all of our energy, so we're gonna be seeing what you could benefit from. But already this is telling me that you've just been very much focusing on achieving your dreams, manifesting what you want, creating the life that you desire, envisioning your future and going for it. This is a card that is very much of yang energy. It's an energy of action, it's an energy of pushing forward, of growth, of accelerating, of not letting anything stand in your way, overcoming obstacles, dedicating yourself. All of that kind of energy is very much the Chariot. Let's find out potentially you could benefit from to help you continue or to help you move forward or anything like that. And we have the Five of Cups and the Six of Pentacles. This is interesting. So what you could benefit from is maybe the first thing that came for me was stop and smell the roses. And it's very, very interesting because as you can see, the person in the Chariot is the same person in the Five of Cups, and they're very recognizable from their haircut. Can you see? So that is synchronistic AF. You've been on the go, you've been going very much forward for your dreams, etc. But you could benefit from, yes, like I said, the first thing I heard is stop and smell the roses. With the Five of Cups and the Six of Pentacles, I'm getting a sense that because you've been so focused on your work or your goals or your achievements or trying to reach some kind of, you know, cross things on your to-do list, etc., you've not really given much time for your emotional well-being, and you've not really given much time for just enjoying little life's pleasures, maybe doing things that nurture your soul instead of just doing things that you feel like you have to do for your success. So maybe you've been really feeding that more physical part of your life, so like I said, reaching goals in terms of finances or health, daily habits, things like that, but not career, you know, but not necessarily focusing on your emotional well-being, because the Five of Cups is really coming to say that it's okay to take time to feel, it's okay to take time to mourn as well. I think that some of you maybe have been kind of pretending that everything is fine. This is why you have the Chariot. Like, if I continue to push forward, I'm not gonna notice that my car is breaking down slowly but surely. I mean, we see in this person driving a car, there's this idea of like, I know my car is slightly breaking down, but if I continue to press and accelerate, I'll get to my destination before it completely breaks down. Like, I don't have time to stop and get my car fixed. Now is not the time. I need to reach my goal, I need to reach my destination. If you think of your car as your emotional well-being or even as your physical well-being, the Five of Cups is coming to say it's maybe you should take a little bit of time to kind of honor what's going on within. Sometimes we want to push through with our goals because we're trying to avoid a certain reality. Sometimes we want to push through with our goals because we want to avoid the fact that we're feeling a certain type of way. Maybe we're feeling hurt, maybe we're feeling scared, maybe we're feeling grief or loss or regret or just fear of the unknown. And it's okay to stop and recognize those feelings, and it's okay to stop and honor that. The Six of Pentacles is really inviting you to enjoy the journey as well as the destination. Enjoy doing things that little life pleasures, stopping for nice meals on your journey. You know, we have the Chariot here, so continuing with this car journey, you should enjoy and stop and look at the scenic view that's on the way. You should enjoy a nice meal. If there's a nice cafe on the road, you should enjoy stopping by and taking a walk in a national park if there's one on your road. Like, it's great to want to get to the destination, but you could be missing out on amazing little life joys and life pleasures and beautiful moments if you just want to get there without actually looking around and taking time to come back to the present moment. So this is what you could benefit from, my pile number one. I sense that maybe listening to your heart a little bit more, honoring your emotions, even if it feels scary, as well as taking more time to just enjoy simple life's pleasure. Here we see someone, you know, listening to people playing music. Like I said, it could be anything that you want to spend your time doing. Okay, so this one is going to be looking at what is stopping you from doing that. What is stopping you from actually doing those kind of behaviors, embracing those behaviors or activities that you know could potentially improve your well-being, that you know could potentially be a form of self-care, etc. And we're gonna see what's standing in your way. Okay, Six of Wands, that's interesting. So what's standing in your way is because you're really on the road to achieving something, my pile number one. You're very consumed right now with an idea of success, whether that is in your career, you're potentially, some of you are going after a promotion, or you're trying to start a new business. You want to be celebrating a particular, you want to be celebrating the success of all the efforts you've put towards a goal, towards a manifestation, towards a dream, towards an idea. And so there's almost no time to be taking for checking in with yourself and enjoying little life's pleasures, because you're like, well, if I do that, I could be missing out on my success. Like, if I do that, I could be wasting time, or I could be missing my opportunity, or someone could steal my moment. Someone could do that before me. There's this idea here of fear of missing your success with the Six of Wands, and the universe is here to tell you that your success is yours. It's yours to claim, and so there will not be such a thing as missing your success. Your success is there for you to grab, but it's important that you reach your destination feeling whole, healthy, feeling well, feeling, you know, taken care of, feeling secure within yourself, emotionally, spiritually, physically, etc. Because otherwise, by the time you reach your destination and you're celebrating your success, you'll be so tired or stressed, or anxious, or anything like that, that you won't even enjoy actually your success. This is very much what could be standing in your way, and something you need to overcome is this fear of missing out on this FOMO kind of thing around success. There is this a bit of a capitalistic kind of idea here that is very imposed by our society, that tend to be forced to be feeling productive all the time, otherwise we're made to be feel like we're not helpful, or to the society, or that we're not actually doing anything productive, that we're not actually being worthy of something. And the universe is there to say you are worthy, even if you take care of yourself, and actually even more so if you decide to go after your goals but still prioritizing your well-being emotionally, especially, and physically. Like, don't overpush yourself, my pal number one, and don't feel like your success will miss out on you, because it will be there. It'll still be there when you reach it. It just means that if you take care of yourself along the way, by the time you get there, you won't feel depleted, and you'll actually be able to enjoy this new life growth, this new step, this new life level. Okay, so this was around how to overcome this fear, how to invite more of this energy in and overcoming what's going on. And we have the Two of Pentacles. So there is this really strong reminder from the universe that you can be doing several things at once, in the sense that you can go after your goals and still take care of yourself. You can try and reach your dreams and still listen to your emotional well-being. You can work forward in your career and still make sure that you are taking time for rest, or for your family, or for your spiritual practice. Whatever it is, this Two of Pentacles is inviting you that it's not an and or situation. It's a both. You can do both. You can be like going after all good chariot energy, but still remembering to counterbalance that with more you time, with more prioritizing some activities that are going to nourish you, with really checking in with your heart and hearing any emotions that are coming through and taking care for that. So this is very much the message right there, is just remember that it's not an and or situation, it's a case of both. It's balance, it's fluidity, it's inviting both of those parts of you to play in your life. We're going to be pulling a card around how, if you were to embrace a little bit more of that in your life, how would that improve your life? Let me zoom you in. Okay, so there, this card is all about go in a bright environment. So bright with, in the sense of nourishing, healing, not just bright in terms of sunny, but more about good vibes. I'm gonna translate it like that because it's a French tech. So this is all this idea about a good vibe environment, an environment that makes you feel thriving, that makes you feel like those beautiful plants, you know, that they can live their best life because they have the right nourishment, the right sun, the right soil, etc. to bloom and live their best life. So if you were to embrace a little bit more of balance in your life and invite more self-time, me-time, etc., it would allow you to bloom, my pile number one. I'm really seeing this similarity here with this idea of plants can bloom when they're in the propitious environment. It's the same for yourself. If you don't give yourself sun, water, and a fertile soil, you won't be able to bloom. Whatever that looks like for you, of course. For some of you, it's going to be spending time with your friends, because that's nourishing. For some of you, it's going to be spending time with your family. Some of you, it's going to be spending time on your own. That's what nourishes you. But there's this idea really of a look at how you can put yourself in a situation in a life where everything around you is nourishing your goals, your dreams, but in a way where it won't deplete your energy but actually help you to really show up the best way you can. And that's a beautiful analogy there with those plants. Beautiful. Okay, let's pull one last card around. Potentially any kind of self-care or healing you could benefit from right now. Still this idea of like last message of healing from the universe. What does the universe want you to know? We have vibration, beautiful card. Those cards are so detailed, so I need to bring you up. Beautiful card with a fairy right there. Vibration, and we also have this intention card with a beautiful unicorn right there. Gorgeous. So nice. Okay, vibration and intention. Put the intention for the universe to provide you with people, places, food, activities that can help your vibrations to remain high. That will allow you to still have the energy to work towards your goals, my pal number one. But you can't be expected to reach your goals if you're always working towards them and not taking time for honoring your vessel, that is your body, your soul, and your mind. So those two cards are really encouragement from the universe that the next time you do your intention, the next time you're trying to manifest something, remember to also manifest not just the money or the car or the job or the relationship, but also manifest activities or feelings that are around nourishment, healing, self-love, keeping high vibration, feeling secure, feeling thriving, being in a nice environment that will make you feel your best. This is very much encouragement from the universe to ask for what you need in order to be in the best state possible to then work on your goals and get the success that you deserve. Beautiful. Okay, let's check what the back of this card that helped you choose that, because there's actually little messages on the back of those. We're going to be checking that out. And it says, learn how to see, realize that everything connects to everything else. To everything else, sorry, beautiful. And it's by Leonardo da Vinci. I love that. So for me, this learn how to see really talks back to this idea of enjoying like smaller life moments, maybe spending time in nature, maybe checking, like really looking at to see where the magic happens in your day-to-day life. So this is what I'm seeing for my panel one. I hope you enjoy this healing, nurturing hug from the universe. You can like, comment, share with anyone you think could benefit from a message of support. And until my next video, as per usual, I am sending you lots and lots of good vibes, and keep navigating the waves of your soul. Bye! Okay, my pile number two, welcome to your reading. So if you chose this particular deck, which is actually called the Tarot of Good Karma, I think, and this particular very cute white rabbit, then this is going to be the reading for you. As I mentioned in the introduction, today our reading is fully dedicated around getting a message of healing, message of self-care, self-love, a hug from the universe, something that's going to be nurturing, especially if you're feeling a little bit down or you just need a little bit of a guidance that's going to be quite gentle, and this is going to be the message for you. Okay, so let's see, we're going to be pulling some tarot cards. The first card we're going to be pulling is around your current state of mind, your current well-being state, where you're at right now. The second card we're going to be pulling is around what kind of self-care or healing do you need at this moment in time, a new activity or a behavior you need to implement that could benefit from your well-being, my pile number two. The third card is what's stopping you from implementing that well-being kind of activity, self-care or anything like that. Sometimes we have fears around, you know, change, etc. We want to know why you haven't yet been doing those changes. And finally, we're going to be looking at how to remedy that, how to overcome that potential fear, and just how to overall improve your well-being, my pile number two. Beautiful. Okay, let's start with your current well-being. Okay, we have the Seven of Wands. That's interesting. My pile number two, you've been feeling stressed lately. You've been feeling anxious, and you've just been feeling potentially, some of you, slightly overwhelmed. Potentially, like, life hasn't been very kind to you lately. You feel like you've just been fighting a battle after battle, having to overcome challenge after challenge, difficult time after difficult time, overcoming everything, keep doing everything that you need to do, showing up for your friends, showing up for your family, showing up for work, and yet it still feels like the universe is throwing curveballs and you're at a point where you're like, okay, I've had enough now, can I just like get a break please? There's this, what I'm really getting is someone who's saying like, I'm over it. So maybe some of you are feeling like you've just been through a lot and you are hoping for a break, you're hoping for a breakthrough, a miracle, a blessing, a parting of clouds. It just feels like your energy is slightly depleted right now. For some of you, you could be feeling anxious about what's to come. Some of you are overly guarding yourself because you've been so going through so much kind of like rocky patch lately that you've like built this huge wall around yourself that to protect you, because you're like, you know what, I can't be hurt anymore. So this is a particular message maybe for some of you to do with relationships or friendships or anything like that. There's this idea there that you are not letting people in right now because you have had enough of getting hurt, so you'd rather protect yourself rather than actually facing the idea that potentially they could see you at your vulnerable side and potentially hurt you. That's not necessarily the right way to be, but it's human, right? Of course we go through those phases. So let's see, some of you also feel like you've had to defend your values and your ideas lately, and that has depleted your energy massively because people are not understanding you, whether that's your colleagues, whether that's your family members, your friends, or your romantic partner, or society at large. There's this idea that you feel like you've had to waste so much energy trying to make people understand where you come from, make people understand your point of view, and you're now at a stage where you're like, well, I'm done trying, like this is just a waste of time. But you haven't quite moved on to the next part, which is, I don't give a shit anymore about what people think, I'm just gonna live my life. You're still at a point where you care, I can sense, and so it's still depleting your energy because you feel like you have to, again, put this huge wall around yourself, defend yourself, because potentially some of you are suffering from external judgment. So that's coming through as well, but we're gonna keep on turning the cards and see what comes next. Okay, so those cards right there, we said that they were going to show what potentially you could benefit from to improve this well-being. And we have the Ten of Cups and the Queen of Wands. Wow, beautiful. Very nice. Surround yourself with people who want the best for you, my pile number two. That is the first thing I heard. If some people are making you feel like you have to wall up, you have to fence up, those people are not for you. Those people are not meant to be in your life. The right people would appreciate you for you, would see you for you, they would not be trespassing your boundaries, and they would respect the boundaries that you've set up. They would respect that, they would respect your opinion, they would respect your way of life. So there's really a strong invitation here to disconnect from anyone who doesn't make you feel your best, and prioritize spending time with people who do see the best in you, who can vibe the same way you do. Also, this Queen of Wands is there as a reminder for your inner power, my pile number two. Did I just say pile number one? I'm sorry, I'm a bit tired today. I'm getting my piles confused. If I called you pile number one before, I am so sorry. The Queen of Wands is really there to say, remind yourself how badass you are. She is the baddest bee in the tarot deck, the Queen of Wands. She doesn't take any shit from anyone. She stands in her own power. She knows she's passionate enough. She knows she's competent enough. She knows she's intelligent enough. She knows she has the talent, the uniqueness, the nerve, the passion, the ideas, and the energy to do whatever she needs to do. She knows she has her own magic. Nobody can take that away from her. Nobody can take that away from you. So remember how badass you are. You have a lot of qualities, my pal number two, that if people can't see, well, that's their loss. There's definitely people either in your life right now or that are gonna come into your life that will see you for who you are, that will appreciate your worth, that will appreciate your inner light, that will appreciate your inner magic. So don't lose faith in that. Disconnect from anyone who makes you feel like you want to climb into a hole and shell up, and actually find the people who make you feel like you can open up and be vulnerable and be honest and be the true you and shine your light bright. And again, I can really tell that if those people are not in your life right now, they will come. This is a sign that they're coming. And if those people are in your life right now, you really need to give them more the time of day and just disconnect with anything or anyone who depletes your energy, my pile number two. Even if it's unfollowing certain accounts on social media or reevaluating the colleagues you talk to that maybe they're just spending their whole time complaining. By the end of the day, you feel like you literally have been drained. Maybe it's time to, not spend so much time in your coffee break listening to those people complain. Maybe you can use that coffee break for something else, go for a walk, whatever it is. There really is this idea of cutting away from that toxic kind of draining, so that you don't feel like you have to be defending yourself and protecting your energy all the time, my pal number two, because it's exhausting. Okay, we're gonna see what's stopping you from doing that, what's potentially standing in your way from, what we've just talked about. And we have the Seven of Pentacles. This is interesting. It's like, it's almost like you don't quite believe in your own worth, my pal number two. With the Seven of Pentacles, you might not realize how special you are, how good of a friend you are, how good of a romantic partner you are, how good of a family member you are. And so potentially this is why you're letting some people take away from you so much and make you and affect you so much, because you're not actually realizing how beautiful your own worth is. I sense this idea of like, the first thing I heard was, the grass isn't always greener next door. You've not really realized how beautiful your own garden is. Maybe you've spent too much time looking at other people's garden, not realizing that what you have within is so beautiful and valuable. You should be so proud of it. You should shine your light. You should own it. You should empower yourself with it. Don't spend time wishing your garden was different. Don't spend time wishing that you were more this or less than. Because it's a waste of your energy. And again, it's just gonna make you feel like you have to defend yourself against everyone and everything that is not really on the same wavelength. If you're always comparing yourself to others, your worth to others, then you will always feel like you have to justify everything you do. But if you accept and love yourself for who you really are, and you honor that, you honor your truth, and you shine bright like the baddest person that you are, you won't need to be looking elsewhere to see how the next neighbor's garden is doing, because you'll be so busy admiring your own. Of course, you can go next door to ask for gardening advice once in a while, and that's great. You know, that's why we ask our friends' opinions sometimes, and we hear and listen when people need our help, etc. But ultimately speaking, we are the gardeners. We are the ones who decide what blooms, what cuts, etc. I don't know what is going on with this gardening metaphor, but this is what the universe is giving me as a message today, so we're gonna run with it. So this is very much what I'm getting is standing in your way, my pile number two, that you need to kind of overcome. Is this kind of appreciating yourself a little bit more? How to best remedy that? How to best overcome that to achieve a better well-being? The Queen of Cups, beautiful, we have two queens, I love that. That makes so much sense because we're doing a self-care, healing kind of reading, so I knew our queens were going to come out because that's what they stand for in tarot anyway, in my version of, you know, my view of tarot anyway. Gorgeous Queen of Cups in this deck. This is a really cute deck, actually. The Queen of Cups is here to tell you that the best way to overcome this low self-worth kind of value is to connect back with your emotions, connect back with your heart, and listen to your intuition. There's this kind of caring side to the Mother of Cup, to the Queen of Cup, which has a tendency to take care of everyone else, but sometimes when you try and pour into everyone else's cup, you end up not actually leaving enough water for yourself. It's the same thing with the, you know, in the plane they say you have to put the oxygen mask on your mouth first before you can help other people. It's the same thing with life. You have to honor your soul's, your heart calls first, listen to your intuition, pour into your own cup first, prioritize self-well-being, self-love, self-worth, before you can then go out into the world and be the best friend that you want to be, or the best partner that you want to be, or the best colleague that you want to be, or family member, whatever it is. Really, with this Queen of Cups, she's inviting you to honor your emotions, taking care for doing things that will make you feel happy, make you feel at peace. Also honoring your gut feelings, any intuition that's coming through, really listen to that. In regards to who's making you feel like you have to defend yourself, what's making you feel like you have to defend yourself, your gut knows. When you feel like that big stomach drop, and I'm not talking about nice butterfly, I'm talking about, you know, when you feel like you have a big icy stone in your stomach, that is usually your body telling you, there's something there that's not vibing with me so well. So listen to that, listen to physical kind of reactions that are actually hints from your soul, hints from your intuition, my pile number two. Beautiful. Okay, we're gonna be moving on to how this would actually evolve, like the outcome. If you were to overcome that, honor more your intuition, overcome that self-worth a little bit, what would be next? Oh my god, look at this. We have love and heart opening. Wow, wow, wow. So what's next? If you get through this and you know, honor your soul, etc., we have the heart opening and we have love. Beautiful combo. So if some of you were looking for a, you know, either a romantic partner, or you were looking to deepen the relationship you already have, then it's definitely on the cards. Or just generally speaking, there is more love to come in your life, in the shape of friends, in the shape of family, in the shape of romantic partner, self-love. You know, this is beautiful, beautiful invitation to say the more you love yourself, this ensures that more love can pour in. The universe can then pour love into your life, blessings, happiness. And with this heart opening, it's just like the opposite. I'm getting this like Pandora's box vibe where it's like sudden, but it's like good things, you know. In the myth, Pandora's box was full of despair, disease, etc., and then before she literally closed it, the last thing that was in the box was hope, and that's the thing that stayed in the box. This box is the opposite of that. It's gagging to come out full of happiness, love, fulfillment, nourishment, well-being. So this is a good box, not a bad box. This is a strong invitation to let love in, and that starts by deconstructing the walls that you've built around your heart, my pile number two. Wow, okay, that's a powerful message right there. Somebody needed to hear that because my nose is so itchy, so somebody definitely needed to hear that. Break that china wall, you don't need it anymore. Okay, Let's pull one last card from the universe. Message of love, your last hug from the universe. Ooh. And we have fiability. So this is around trust. This is around trusting your guidance, trusting your intuition, trust in the universe, trust in your guide, trust in yourself, trust that you're enough, trust that you have the passion, the talent, the uniqueness necessary to shine your light, trust that you will meet the right people that see you for you, trust that you know the tune to your own life, and if some people are not dancing to your tune, it's because they're not meant to be on the same music as you, and that's okay. Nobody can tell you that you're dancing wrong to the tune of your life, because it's your tune, you do what you want with it. Gorgeous. Okay, we're gonna wrap up the reading by checking what this little card said, because there's actually a little message here on the back of those cards. Seek magic every day. Wow, beautiful. That's a beautiful last message. So my pile number two, this is the last message for you. Seek magic every day. So this is what I'm seeing for my pile number two. I hope you enjoyed this reading. If you did, don't hesitate to like, comment, share with anyone who you think could benefit from a hug from the universe as well. And until my next video, as per usual, I'm sending you lots and lots of good vibes, and keep navigating the waves of your soul. Bye! Okay, my pile number three, welcome to your reading. So if you chose this particular deck, which is called the Neo Tarot, or this beautiful hummingbird imagery right there, this is going to be the message for you. As I mentioned in the introduction, today we're checking out a message of healing, a message of self-care, a message of a hug from the universe, what you need to hear to improve your well-being right now. And we're going to be pulling some tarot cards. This is, you know, for anyone who's been feeling like they need a little bit of guidance, and we're going to be checking first your emotional general well-being, like what's going on emotionally, spiritually, etc. What is your well-being right now? My pile number three. The next cards you're going to be pulling in are around what you could benefit from in terms of new habits or activities or anything like that that could improve your well-being. Then we're going to be checking out why you haven't implemented those changes yet. Maybe there's some fears, maybe there's some blockages around that. We're going to be digging into that a little bit more. And finally, we're going to be checking out the outcome of you overcoming that. What would be coming for you? What would be the next step? And we'll be putting some oracle cards at the end. Okay, let's check out your well-being right now. We have the Ten of Cups. Beautiful. So I can sense that actually things seems to be pretty good for my pile number three, or at least things could be worse. But the Ten of Cups, you know, so the Ten of Cups is the last card in the cup suit, so it's linked to emotional well-being, it's linked to feeling fulfilled, emotional fulfillment, being surrounded by people who understand you, who see you, who value you, all of that good stuff. So that's wonderful, that could be the case for a lot of you. The Ten of Cups also come with another flip side, which is this idea of things are too good to be true right now. This kind of like, things are going too well and I'm not used to it, so I'm kind of waiting for the other shoe to drop. Maybe some of you are thinking like you're just kind of waiting for something bad to happen, kind of feeling a bit on edge, like really this idea of things are a bit too good right now, like maybe I'm used to things not going so well in my relationships or in my friendships or in my personal development or anything like that, and so I'm kind of expecting for a detour, a stop in the road, a block or some kind, and I can't quite enjoy how peaceful and good things feel right now because I'm just waiting for some crap to come. Or there's another side to that, and that's gonna be speaking to some of you as well. I feel like that maybe you're convincing that everything is good, but deep down there's some kind of like bubbling intuitive hits, bubbling kind of gut feelings, but you've just been pushing that down right now of like, I don't want to know. Let me pretend, let me live in my fantasy right now. I'm happy, even though maybe I know it's a fantasy. I'm happy to be in the fantasy right now. I don't want to be told the truth. This is a very particular message. It's not going to speak to everyone, but if you know, you know. Okay, let's see what you could benefit from at this moment in time, my pile number 3, what could improve your well-being? 10 of Swords and 10 of Wands. Yes, so the more it goes, the more it seems that not everything is so well, or at least either things are going well in your life, and again, you've been really just not able to enjoy it because you're just waiting for some crap to happen. You're just like almost like on getting that post-traumatic vibe where even once you're after the traumatic event, you can't quite breathe, you can't quite relax, etc., because you're still on edge, your nervous system is still very much activated. Or some of you have pink colored glasses on right now where you're trying to pretend that everything is going well when deep down you're not really feeling it. You're in relationships that you're not really feeling, you're in friendships that you're not really feeling, and you're trying to kind of force things to work because you just want it to work so bad, because maybe you don't want to shake the status quo, maybe you don't want to change, maybe you know you're scared of what would happen if you were to speak your true mind. But those two cards are really saying that you need to be honest with yourself regardless of your situation right now. You need to check in with your mental health and check in with your physical health and make sure that you're not burning the candle at both ends. For some of you with this 10 of Wands, there's this idea of potentially honoring your gut feelings, like I was saying. So if your body is feeling a certain type of way around someone and they just don't make you feel good, they don't make you feel at ease, then you need to be honest with yourself, and it's okay to walk away. It's okay to be at a crossroad and be like, you know what, I wish you well, but this is not for me anymore. For some of you, this idea of maybe you're not able to fully enjoy the present moment because you're still very much affected by what's happened in your past, and so you need to do a little bit of work around your mental health, more so around your potentially your anxiety, or how you've been speaking with yourself, thinking the worst, etc., etc. Some of you could benefit from asking for help there, whether it's from a friend or a professional, or just doing a bit more of work on yourself around being grounded in the present moment. Maybe some meditation could be very helpful, reconnecting to trying to rework your, like trying to implement new neural pathways where your brain wouldn't be so quick to jump to the worst situation possible as soon as something happens. So that's kind of the idea around those two cards, that what you could benefit from is honoring your physical reaction, honoring your physical energy, resting when you need, listening to your gut instinct, and also really paying attention to how your mind is potentially always thinking the worst and how you can change those habits, how you can implement daily little things, little steps that would help you control that. Let's see what is stopping you from doing that, my pile number 3. Why you haven't really been looking at that part of you. 5 of Pentacles, okay. So this is really the pile of people who've been hurt. I can really feel it. This is my pile of people who've been going through a lot. And why you haven't done that work, and why you're potentially, some of you are, like I said, waiting for the other shoe to drop or wearing like pink colored glasses right now, is because the common theme is that you've been hurt and you're afraid of being hurt again. Whether that is hurt by people or hurt by life, there's this idea that you haven't quite overcome this feeling of loss, this feeling of solitude, this feeling of not being understood, not being seen, not being safe, not feeling like you are able to speak how you feel, not being heard. That's something that's coming through strongly. But also with this 5 of Pentacles is this idea of something was taken from you, whether that was some of you it was maybe your job, or maybe it was a relationship that ended. For some of you it could be health issues, anything like that. Something has happened, something was taken away from you that has really scarred you, as you know it should. Your experience, your feelings are of course totally valid, but I can sense that it's like affecting still to this day your ability to enjoy life's beauty that you could see right now, and it's not allowing you to be grateful for the things that you do have right now. And so what's standing in your way of a better well-being, my pile number 3, is really trying to be grateful for what you do have instead of overspending time looking at what you don't have. And I know it can be so difficult. I understand. I won't go into my personal life, but I really understand what it's like to feel like you're lacking and to still really struggle to find things to be grateful for. But you can start so small. You can start with, okay, I'm grateful for the fact that I have internet and I can watch this video on YouTube. I'm grateful for the fact that I'm breathing. I'm grateful for the fact that I have water, running water that I can drink every day. I'm grateful for the fact that I have a roof over my head. Like, you need to start with being grateful for all the blessings in your life in order to be able to rewire your brain to not be so much on like survival mode, anxious, kind of waiting for the attack, waiting for something bad to happen, waiting for the shoe to drop kind of vibe. Okay, so this is very much the fear, the blockage that's standing in your way is this scarcity mindset and difficulty to be grateful considering you've been hurt so much. Okay, let's see if you were to overcome this, which I'm sure you will, what would happen. Wow, look at that. We have the Nine of Cups. So the Nine of Cups is a beautiful, beautiful message because this is saying, instead of waiting for others to make you happy, instead of counting on life circumstances to make you happy, which actually does not work, because look, we have those two things, like if you're waiting for the perfect circumstances, if you're waiting for people to try and help, you know, fix things when you know it, deep down it's internally that you need to heal, that happiness will just be fake. It will be built on unreliable foundation. If you actually overcome that, if you heal the wounds of what you've gone through, if you look at your past and actually take the time to talk to the people you need to, take care of your body, try and overcome those, that be more grateful for the day to day, taking time for grounding yourself, everything we've talked about, it will mean feeling secure in oneself and you being the source of your own happiness. And if you're happy within yourself, which is exactly what the Nine of Cups is about, if you're happy within yourself, you then can be happy in any relationship that you are, whether it's friendships, family, etc. Because you're not then entering the world from a place where you already feel so raw, because everything has been like sandpaper to your soul. So if you feel full within yourself, if you feel secure within yourself, everything will flow so much better for my pile number three. Your relationships will be smoother. Your life will be easier, coming from a place where you are actually proud of yourself, you love yourself, you've taken care of yourself. There's this kind of reparenting yourself kind of vibe for my pile number three, so there might be some inner child work there that you're going to be doing, but that's a beautiful message of hope. It's a message of empowerment from the universe to say, like, you can be the source of your own happiness. That way nothing or no one will shaken your foundation, because you know whatever happens, you'll be fine because you've got yourself. And that is beautiful, because you know what? You are beautiful. That is exactly what I'm hearing right now. And that's an amazing message for my pile number three. Okay, let's see what's next for you once you do all of that, which is amazing. I'm so here for you going through this healing process. Let's see what's next for my pile number three. Wow. Look, we have practice gratitude and practice spirituality. So gratitude, we've talked about that. We had the Five of Pentacles. Be grateful for every little thing in your life. Start small. It doesn't have to be huge, but you do need to be more grateful to see life from a point of view where you'll have even more things to be grateful for. The more you're grateful for a little thing, the more you see that there are things to be grateful for. And spirituality could be very helpful for some of you. Like I was saying, you know, meditation is coming very strongly. Some of you, maybe you pull card too. Like maybe you work with tarot or oracle, reiki or anything like that, where it's more spiritual practices, affirmation, whatever works for you. You are invited to use your spiritual practice as a way to anchor in your own happiness. And again, where you don't need anyone else to make you happy, because it comes from a place where you make yourself happy, and that is more solid, that is more grounded, and that is more like nourishing for the long term. Beautiful. Okay, let's pull one last message of guidance, of love from the universe for my pile number three. Wow, see, oh my god, this is like so beautiful. We have unconditional love. The universe loves you, your guides love you, your higher self love you, even when you feel like you don't have any love in your life. Remember that there are so much energy, so much love, even in what we cannot see. Remember that you can give you the gift of unconditional love, and that is the biggest blessing that you could give yourself. The biggest blessing that you could give yourself, my pal number three. It's actually pure magic. Pure magic. Oh my god, this is so beautiful. I'm actually like so humbled by this reading from my pal number three. Very, very powerful reading. Okay. So let's check what your message here said. There was a little quote on the back of this. This is what helped you pick this particular pile. So we're gonna see what it says. And it says, beauty is a nectar which intoxicates the soul. Beautiful. So remember to not spend all your time looking at the beauty elsewhere. I feel like this is really coming back to this idea of spending too much time looking at what, you know, potentially you don't have, instead of remembering that everything you need, everything you have is within, and that you are beautiful, you are worthy just as you are. Gorgeous. So this is all I have for my pile number three. I hope that you enjoyed the reading. You might see hummingbird imagery in the next few days or weeks. This could be a little reminder of this message. So pay attention to where the hummingbird comes into your life, my pile number three. If you enjoyed the reading, don't hesitate to give my video a thumbs up. You can like, comment, share with anyone who you think could benefit from an empowering message. And if you want to subscribe, I would also love to have you. I post empowering tarot reading, pick a card guidance, all of that good stuff. And until my next video, as per usual, I am sending you lots and lots of good vibes, and keep navigating the waves of your soul. Bye!